It wasn't Larry that said his foot was hanging off. Butchie Gergis beat Larry to the house and told mom and dad that Billy's foot was hanging off.
Because he was too exhausted.
That's right.
He only ran 3 miles.
Said, no, no, Denny.
Did I?
Yeah, you did. He told mom and dad everything.
Sorry, correction to the story.
I heard the story that I was the one that did it. Karen, what do you think, Karen?
But Larry was crying. Larry was crying. He was so worried about Billy.
I was, man. Here's my best friend. He's laying on the ground, bleeding like a suck pig.
He actually only ran about 30 feet.
He's got a stink, a whole stink, and it's, you know, in his toilet. I said, jeez.
So Billy Gergis met me in the house. It only can happen in their lives, I tell you.
So, honey, what I'm trying to tell you is be careful. Don't let him, if he puts a tent up, make sure he has some adult supervision.
Don't let him take you camping.
Here's the watch me.
Okay.
Hey, Larry, is that why we have no tent here today?
Right. No tents allowed.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Go ahead.
No, yes.
All right.
Now the brave. Okay.
I'm honored today to be her maid of honor. We've been close friends for a long time since grad school, freshly out of college. That was like 2 years ago. Well, we both look very young, right? She and I were in the same dorm room, starting from second year in grad school, but not the first year. The first year, we never really spoke with each other because we were not in the same program. One thing that she struck me and my friends were, she had beautiful long hair, and whatever the weather was, she was always in a skirt.
Sorry.
So she struck us as someone who is just really pretty and knows how to enjoy life and very smart at the same time. And then in my second year in grad school, we happened to be in the same dorm room, and I realized how sweet a person she also is. Very genuine, down to earth, always has a positive outlook on life. But aside from that, she's pretty fun.
Yes, she is.
There was a three of us living in the dorm room, and that was, I will tell you the time. That was a time when China was just opening up. Mm-hmm. So people were still dressing in a very plain way. And then she proposed an idea. Actually, the three of us would always go out over the weekend to have a proper meal in a restaurant. We didn't have much money, but we kind of took turns to treat each other. Mm-hmm. So she proposed that we dress up and we did something outrageous. And she actually said, let's bring a pack of cigarettes. China was just opening up, and we were in the restaurant on our hill, and she challenged the two of us to smoke, and then I was like, sure, so, with shock, yeah, kind of disgust. Smoking, and all the time I was like, I'm not holding my cigarette right. Do I inhale? She's like, I have no idea. And we lost in touch for a while because I came here to study, and back then a lot of people didn't have telephones. And then with just written correspondence, it's very easy to lose contact, and we did. I was actually in Boston at the time, and I had no idea that she came to the States. She was shopping at Macy's, and then she ran into a mutual friend of ours. So in the age without Facebook, we actually reconnected again. So she just called me out of the blue. So but we kept in touch ever since, and she has been a sweet, dear, positive influence in my life. So I'm very honored today to be here, and even though I've only spoken with Bill once on the phone and just met him yesterday for the first time, he's just a really warm, considerate person. So I want to propose a toast. In ancient China, there was a beautiful love poem for an emperor who lived about more than 1,000 years from now. He and his wife were just a really lovely couple. So a famous poet back then wrote a poem about their love. So I just want to use that poem to be my toast to them. So may you be, okay, I have to remember that. May you be two lovebirds flying together, and may you be two trees with your branches growing into each other. So,
thank you so much.
Yeah. 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 Beautiful. Yep.
Okay, here's. Thank you, Brian. Cheers.
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 Cheers. Yeah, I'd like to have a toast here.
Thank you, John.
To both Larry and Bill.
Wait a minute. Like it's something that I'm there.
No, Larry, this is about the wisdom of your elders. The very first club I ever joined, it's called the Amphibian Club. I wasn't in first grade yet, and Bill and Larry are in second grade.
I remember. Thanks for reminding us.
So I looked up to him for guidance.
Oh, big mistake.
They had already joined and had been experienced explorers. In amphibian clubs, we live in the land, in the sea, and whatever, we go anywhere. We're explorers.
Right.
They said, John, we've been through this initiation, now it's your turn. I had to jump 12 feet from a high platform, from a hayloft, and land on the ground. I was really scared.
Billy Marsh.
Yeah, Billy Marsh.
I remember
president,
that.
Our neighbor. They said, John, we're here to give you guidance and wisdom. You can do it. So I jumped. And I was all right. And the next thing we had to do, he had a corn cob pipe, and he said, Johnny, you have to smoke this corn silk. So I smoked the corn silk, and I was gagging. And that was the second test.
Hey!
He said the first two were easy now. He said the third thing you gotta do is you gotta eat a rabbit turd.
Anybody else?